Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome to episode or video number 3 of Restoring the R30 Neil Peart DW Drum Kit. On this episode, I have gotten the green light to go ahead and get everything that was on my list on order. So it's going to be a while. I think some of the hardware, like the boom stands, are going to take about 90 to 120 days to get them back from silver plating. But I'm very excited to do it. I opted out. I was going to put Evans heads on the kit, but come to find out, DW actually, you know, makes the factory heads to Remo, their Remo heads. So just to make it authentic, I'm going to go ahead and get the original DW heads that came on them. It's like a, they call it clear coated or coated clear. So it's got these little target areas around the rim that are coated. So that's an update. And I have begun to disassemble the pedal boards for the kick pedal and hi-hat stand. I've only knocked one of those out. And I'm sending it off to have it replated and get an estimate to see how much that's going to run. But super excited, and I can't wait to get going. And so we're basically here disassembling the pedals. So I've already taken apart the sleeve. So that's the plate right there. It should be pretty easy for them to replate, I guess. Hoping it's not going to cost too much. There's the, that's the pedal board right there, just a solid piece of metal. This is the bottom part of that. And we're actually down to bracket. It's fairly simple, believe it or not, to take it apart. I just, you know, making mental notes, little snapshot pictures to make sure that I put it back together correctly, which I don't think it's going to be too difficult. So this is basically the part that connects the heel plate to the foot plate. So we're just going to, looks like there's two bearings that are on the inside. So you got a bearing on this side and a bearing on this one. And I'm just going to use my manpower here to take it apart. Taking this stuff apart, if you, you know, like anything else, try your best to actually keep track of what you're doing. So that way, you're going to put it back together, you know, like, oh man, I thought this went there and this went there, and nothing's working, nothing's fitting, and I've just ruined it. So, they still make this, believe it or not, I didn't know that. Find out it's $25.99 for the 9,000 double pedal gold plated. That's pretty crazy. So, I wouldn't pay that much. I wouldn't pay that much for the new one they got out. That new direct drive, I think it's like $1,000. I'm just not into that, man. I can't see myself paying that kind of money for a bass drum pedal. The most expensive pedal I ever bought was a Axis, and it was a double bass pedal. And at the time, I think it was like 98. It was $500, and that was like stupid expensive at the time. So, and then I hated it. I just didn't like it. So, I'm gonna speed some things up because I gotta get a hammer, and I gotta tap those bearings out. Because they're not one to come, so.
Can I try to get them out?
Skip forward real quick.
The
There we go. These are our pieces. So I just have a little collection, and I'm going to send it off up there and see what they can do. So, let's see how I'm basically putting them in order. So that's how they sit in the actual casing. So that way I don't mess anything up when I put it back together. To move on to the next pedal. There you have it, folks. So this is all my stuff on this table. You can't really see it, but I have like little screws and stuff. That is everything that has come from the slave pedal. So I have four pieces that I'm sending to have replated. Man, I hope it doesn't cost too much. So, I'm really not asking for a lot. So, but that's the slave pedal. So now I'm gonna move on to the main. Okay, so we just finished up the hi-hat stand. I was doing maybe three of those, so that one's all done. And my hands hurt, so I have everything ready. So I did notice some stuff on the hi-hat stand that I did not like. A couple of rusty spots. I don't know. I mean, I'm thinking a hi-hat stand like that's going to cost over $1,000. So I might be able to dress it up and make it look pretty and stuff, but this is the hi-hat stuff. Pretty easy to take apart. It was just like, you know, any of the other pedals. So, everything's ready. I got my box, and everything's ready to go. So, I'll give you another update when I get everything back and I start to get other stuff in. And Landon's got a question for me real quick. Hang on just a second.
It's not really a question.
There you go. That was a question, wasn't it? He said, can I hold that? That's a question. Right? Okay. So, all right. So, that's all for now. So, thanks for watching. And, you know, keep checking back because I'm going to have more updates and episodes and stuff like that. So, see you later.